Hey guys, what is up? It's Haley. Welcome back to my channel. Today I thought it would be really fun to add kind of like a little twist on the regular thrifting video. And I actually saw Emily Wask here on YouTube thrifting for Urban Outfitter Dupes. I thought it was a really cool idea. If you guys do want to go ahead, check her video out. It was really awesome. So I thought today I would go ahead and do the same thing because I feel like here in Toronto, I've been getting really lucky finding things at the thrift stores that you would definitely see at Urban Outfitters. So I'm going to take you guys in with me. For once, I actually remembered to bring my big Value Village reusable bag. So hopefully we'll find enough stuff to fill this thing up. When there's a cart available, it's a good sign. So we're starting off in the men's section like always because I do truly feel like in the men's section you can find the most athletic branded items that you would definitely see at Urban Outfitters, such as Adidas, Tommy Hilfiger, Nike, you know, the classics. So we're gonna go ahead and check out denim right here and then check out the sweatshirts. So I truly believe there is no better Urban Outfitter dupes than finding yourself a really sick pair of Levi's to wear as mom jeans. Like, look at these Levi's, literally in the perfect, absolute perfect shade. I love them. The great thing is when you find stuff such as this, either stains or some rips or whatever, you can always ask for a further discount on the price. And then either fix it yourself if you know how to sew, which I do, thanks mom. So I'll try these on because I'm obsessed with the shade.
Now we're at my personal favorite in the wintertime, which is the activewear sweaters. Do I need more? No. Will I still look for them? Always.
Half zip sweaters have been really popular in Urban Outfitters and still have big graphics and still have sweaters in really bright colors. Ooh, tie-dye guys, huge, huge, huge thing that is coming back. If it didn't have this like hockey logo, I would definitely have picked that up too.
Nautica quarter zip. I've been seeing these ones with like a quarter zip also everywhere, and I like this dark red.
Look at this yellow Tommy fleece. Like, holy. It's a quarter zip and it's a fleece, like, oh. And again, in the big hoodie section is this Nike SB shirt. I love really simple black hoodies like this with a white graphic. I feel like if you're gonna do an athleisure look, it's really great to have ones like these. And just found this little Champion hoodie as well. I'm not gonna pick it up because I know myself, I'm not gonna wear it because I don't really like jackets that are full zips. It's not necessarily my style. If this was a hoodie, then definitely, so I will leave it behind. This is a really cool old school looking Fila shirt, but it does look like it's a little bit worn and it has some staining, so I'm gonna leave that behind too. Oh, remember guys, I told you I would pick up that sweater if it had no logo because it's tie-dye, and this is just a perfect simple tie-dye top. Literally, prayers answered.
Back at the kids section right now. Last time I got really lucky with that Dodge like sporty bomber jacket at the kids section. So in kids extra extra large, I found this perfect Adidas hoodie. I mean, these ones are a staple in Urban Outfitters, so definitely gonna pick it up. And I found this one too. It's so cute. It's definitely way too small for me, but if it was a bigger size, oh, I would love it, like Looney Tunes. Come on. Very old school Nike. Again, a little bit too small, so I'm gonna stick to the extra large, but definitely check out the kids section, especially if you're more petite. You could for sure fit into some of these items.
Like, windbreakers and jackets are huge on Urban Outfitters too. So there's this one, which honestly, I have enough of those, so I'm not gonna get it. And this one also, just a Fila windbreaker, swish swish.
Literally, t-shirt section, I went through all of it.
And in all of these t-shirts, I found four little things that I feel like I would definitely see on Urban Outfitters. So first one is this pretty cool like Tommy t-shirt, and I feel like this cropped would look really nice. Then this one I probably won't pick up because I already have so many similar ones, but it also has that big graphic logo going on. This one I thought was really cool, and I feel like if I crop it, it would be sick. But even if I like leave it as a t-shirt dress, that's cute. And then this one also, either cropped or t-shirt dress, we'll see. But that's everything I found in the t-shirt section.
Okay, so made it to the women's section. I know it's about time. And I'm here in the pants area, and I'm looking for some really funky pants. If you guys do follow me on Instagram, which if you don't, you definitely should. I think if you do like my style on my photos, you would get a lot of outfit inspo. And I love wearing like funky pants. Like, plaid is one of my favorites. I actually saw this skirt in the women's section. I'm gonna try it on, see how it fits. Like I said, plaid pants are everything right now. And I found this really awesome pair. Like, look at this plaid. It's such a cool funky blue, but it's honestly like a zero. Like, I don't even think this is gonna get over my waist. But they're so nice, like, I'll try them on anyway. Maybe they're like the sisterhood of the traveling pants, magical pants, and they'll fit me. If you don't have the patience to go through every single one, you could just scan the entire aisle and look for some really funky, cool patterns or sick fabrics that you feel like you would love to see in a pair of pants.
Guys, you see this sweater? I literally just found such a good dupe. This one does have the pattern going like all the way down. Oh, so cute, it's like grandpa chic. They have like the exact same ones in Urban Outfitters, so I'm pretty sure like $35. Look at this one, it's like two of my favorite trends in one. It's like a snakeskin belt with neon. That's actually insane. Starting off with a couple of the vintage tees. This is the first Chaps one. It is kind of huge. I would actually probably roll up the sleeve, maybe even make a little stitch so that it could stay rolled up. But I really love the graphic on the front, very sporty. Same kind of idea with this big oversized black one. Sleeves are huge, so either crop that or I'm gonna pin them up. Honestly, even as a t-shirt dress, maybe in the summertime. One of the softest t-shirts I've ever tried on. I really like the material. Obviously it has a nice little Tommy flag, but I just really like the size of this. It's like oversized, but as you can see, there's no shoulder here that's cutting me off, so it's actually pretty flattering. And I love this neckline too, just an added little detail. Yes, I am so into the tie-dye. I am so glad that it's coming back. And on Urban Outfitters, we are seeing so many different tie-dye tops like this, and this t-shirt is kind of like the perfect way to express that. Big oversized Tommy sweater with like the zip. This vintage yellow is obviously my favorite color if you don't know, and it's just so fuzzy. I feel like a newborn little chick. That's exactly it. This is my new chick sweater. Really, really sick Nike hoodie. Obviously it's just a basic black, my favorite kind, but like look at this inside. Polka dots, I love. Kind of feeling the all black vibes, I gotta say. So trying on literally the sweater version of that t-shirt, and I didn't think I could be more obsessed, but I am. Very Urban Outfitter vibes, and I really love the colors on this one as well. All this color in the winter is like the best thing ever. I have a feeling if I try this one on, I'm gonna want it too, because I like that Nike one better, so this one's gonna stay. Yeah, so skirt, way too small. That's always my problem, finding something that fits my waist and my hips at the same time. No way that's gonna close. But I love this plaid skirt. It's not gonna close, but they're so nice. This is like my new goal, to find these exact pants in a bigger size. But like, you win some, you lose some. Tried on these distressed light wash Levi's. They actually are a little bit big, but I'm loving the look of them. So maybe if I just add a belt, it will still look nice. And the natural hole that it probably developed over the years. Last off, I have this like cute pleated little mini skirt. I noticed Urban Outfitters has so many different kinds of like mini skirts, especially with pleats. So I saw this one and it's my perfect size, and it's a nice white color. I feel like with some docks, I can really edge up this look, you feel? So I'm ready to go pay, but before, I did ask her about the Levi's because like I said, it's kind of starting to rip a bit. So she did take $2 off, which is not much, but it's something. Always ask for discounts if you feel like you can get it. Guess you could say this was a really, really successful trip. There you go, sit all tight. And we're back. Honestly guys, I really didn't expect to get that lucky. I think I got some pretty awesome stuff that like I'm really excited to style and show you guys. That is it for this Come Thrift With Me. I really hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to give it a big thumbs up if you do. You will see these items again. I'm gonna be posting a huge thrift haul combining another thrift trip that I did yesterday right after this video in a couple of days. So be sure to subscribe and stay tuned for that video coming up. Turn on your little bell so you can watch it as soon as it goes live. But yeah, thank you all for coming with me. I always have a blast when we go thrifting together, and I can't wait to see you in my next one. Bye! I always do that, guys, like hand sanitizer. Hand sanitizer!